One of the biggest reasons why I switched from Canon to Sony several years ago is because of this reason, which means that I have to carry fewer lenses with me on my photo and video shoots. It's actually two reasons, but they effectively do the same thing, which is zoom into my shot without using any extra lenses or tools. I use these all the time, especially when shooting with my prime or fixed focal length lenses. So in this video, I'll explain what these concepts are, how they work, and how to turn them on in your camera. The first is called APS-C or Super 35 crop mode. This only works on Sony full-frame cameras, like the Sony a7 III and the a7 IV. So if you have a point-and-shoot or an APS-C camera, this won't work for you. It also only works on Sony full-frame lenses, not on crop sensor lenses. But what it does is it crops in 1.5 times, so you get a tighter field of view from your full-frame camera. So if I use my Sony 20mm f1.8 full-frame lens on the Sony a7 IV, I can turn on crop mode, and now I can shoot at 1.5 times the focal length, which is 30mm. And using this method, your aperture isn't affected like it often is if you shoot using a lens extender, so I still retain the f1.8 aperture. But the one thing you can lose is image quality, but only in the form of photo megapixels. Video quality is not affected when using APS-C crop mode, but photo quality is. So if you have a 24 megapixel sensor, your photo quality will go down to 10.66 megapixels per image. So if shooting photography, APS-C mode is best used on a high megapixel camera, like the Sony a7 CR or the Sony a7 R5, for the least loss in photo quality. So how do you activate APS-C or Super 35 mode? Well, it does depend on which camera you have, but on the Sony a7 C2, hit the menu button, go down to Shooting, and Image Quality Recording, and scroll down to APS-C Super 35 Shooting. There are three options here. If you turn it off, the camera will always shoot full-size image sensor photos and videos. So if you put a full-frame lens, like this 20mm lens, on your camera, it'll shoot normally at 20mm. But if you put a crop sensor lens on the camera, you'll see the edges of the lens in your shot. This is really not ideal. If you turn this mode on, the opposite happens, where the camera always shoots in cropped mode. So a full-frame lens like my 20mm will shoot 30mm, and my crop sensor lens will shoot 30mm. Now for most people, especially those of you that shoot with both full-frame and crop sensor lenses, the best thing to do is to use auto mode, where the camera automatically detects if you're shooting with a full-frame or a crop sensor lens, and makes automatic adjustments. Now personally, I use APS-C mode so often that I've programmed it to the rear C1 button on my camera, so that when I trigger it, it automatically goes into crop mode, and then back to full-frame mode when I tap it again. I do this by tapping on the menu button, going to Setup, Operation Customize, Custom Key / Dial Settings, and assigning my rear one button number 1 to APS-C Super 35. To me, this is the fastest and easiest way to take advantage of this crop mode, and it truly makes me feel like I'm using two lenses at once, when in fact I'm only using one. The second way to zoom applies to most Sony cameras out there. I've used this on my full-frame and crop sensor cameras, as well as point-and-shoots like the RX100 and the Sony ZV-1 cameras. It's called Clear Image Zoom, and it lets you zoom in by a factor of 2 times on any Sony camera or lens. Now, unlike APS-C or Super 35 mode, which I mentioned earlier, Clear Image Zoom does not achieve zoom by cropping into your shot. It also is not the same as digital zoom, so there's not a dramatic loss in image quality. According to Sony, when using Clear Image Zoom, the camera first zooms optically at the maximum optical magnification, then uses Clear Image Zoom technology to enlarge the image an additional 2 times, producing sharp, clear images, despite the increased zoom ratio. So basically, it's enlarging the image while also retaining the original image resolution. Now, even though Clear Image Zoom works on just about every modern Sony camera and lens, there are still some restrictions. The exact restrictions depend on the camera model, but across the board, I noticed that it only works in photo mode, not in video mode. And the photos can only be shot in JPEG, not RAW or RAW plus JPEG. There is also some loss of autofocus, so you unfortunately don't get full autofocus features when using it, at least not on my a7 IV. But like APS-C mode, you do retain your f-stop or your aperture. In general, I find clear image zoom to be really helpful during my photo shoots, especially when I'm shooting with a prime or fixed focal length lens, which I often do. As far as how to turn on clear image zoom, the process varies according to your camera model, but on the Sony a7 C2, I hit the menu button, go to shooting, and scroll down to zoom. Make sure that the zoom range is set to clear image zoom. And now if I back out to the previous menu, I can go to zoom and use my thumb wheel, or the top and front zoom wheels, to zoom in and out. In this menu, there's another setting here called fixed speed, and you can use this to set your desired number so that if you're in the clear image zoom toggle, you can use the left and right buttons on the thumb wheel to slowly or quickly zoom into your shot. Now, like APS-C mode, I use clear image zoom so often that I have it set as a custom button, so I just have to press the left side of my thumb wheel to activate it. I do this by tapping on the menu button, going to Setup, Operation Customize, Custom Key / Dial Setting, and assigning my rear 2 button number 2 to zoom. So those are two ways to get extra zoom out of your Sony camera. There are restrictions for both of these methods, so they're not ideal for using all the time. But as a professional photographer and videographer, I use them both so frequently that I always have them assigned to custom buttons on my camera. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.